Hello learners, good morning all of you. I, Dr. Tomar here with the poem The Felling of Banyan Tree for the English, that is the compulsory English. Now, yesterday I had explained you this poem. Now today we would be moving towards the summary of the poem so that the entire poem which needs explanation would be rounded up. Now, the questions which are asked in unicity pattern for this poem is the summary related to the banyan tree. Then, describe the banyan tree in the yard of poet's ancient home. And the last question which is asked, describe the process of felling of banyan tree and also the act of cutting down the tree. Now, if the entire summary is explained to you, as I had explained you the poem yesterday, today I would be explaining the summary so that the entire poem would be covered. Now the different points which you would be including in the summary is the introduction part related to the author. As I told you yesterday that he is born in 1938, 2009. He is a teacher, painter. He is a bilingual poet. He writes in two languages, that is Marathi and English. And he has written many poems. Traveling in a Cage is one of his most important poems, a renowned one. Now, this is the first part, that is introduction related with Tilakchitri. Now, the second part, significance. Now, this poem refers to the cutting down of banyan tree. जैसे हमने कल बताया थे, बट वृक्ष कहते हैं banyan tree, वो symbolic tree माना जाता है. और it has a typical significance which tells about the cutting of banyan tree in the ancient yard of poet's home. Now, the direction given for cutting the tree is by the father. The father wanted that the tree should be cut down, which was there in the yard. Now, as all of you know, in the summary, next point we would be shifting towards after writing the significance. What is the poem about? As I've told you, the poem is about cutting down of banyan tree, which was directed by the father. We are going to shift to the next point, that is trees help us in enhancing life. Trees, the different parts of the tree are very useful for mankind. The trees are useful as a fuel, it gives us food for medicinal purposes, then it gives us timber, and many more uses of trees are there. Now, nostalgic view of the grandmother, that is Tilakchitri's mother, for cutting down the trees. As yesterday I have told you that Tilakchitri's mother was very nostalgic for cutting down the trees. She was a religious lady and she did not want that the trees should be cut down because she felt that the trees are very sacred and it should be worshipped. As all of you know that Vatavruksha is worshipped by women's lady or ladies generally, and therefore she also felt that it is a religious tree and therefore it should not be cut down, and therefore she was against the opinion of Tilakchitri of cutting down the tree. Now, destruction of the tree. But as it was decided by Tilakchitri's father to cut down the trees, the tenants who were residing or staying in the house were ordered to vacate the house so that the trees can be cut. There were different trees which were going to be cut. There were three trees, I have told you yesterday also, Odumbar, Shoka and Neem tree. They were cut down. But cutting down of banyan tree was a great problem for the tree cutters. The next point, here it is. Now, the great problem for the cutters to cut down the banyan tree was because it was a very huge tree, massive tree. It was a very big tree and the roots of these trees were very deep inside the ground. And therefore, it was very difficult to cut down the tree. Now, the three things which have been described for the banyan tree is the banyan tree was three times as big as the house of the Tilakchitri. Next is the trunk. It had the circumference of 50 feet. Jo gherao kehte ho, pura jhaad ka 50 feet tha. It was covered, 50 feet ground was covered, and it was very difficult for the cutters to cut down. And the next thing was the aerial roots were hanging down. जैसे हमने कल कहा एरियल रूट्स को हैंगिंग रूट्स भी कहते हैं. आपने देखा होगा ये बनियन ट्री को द किड्स जस्ट दे होल्ड द रूट्स ऑफ बनियन ट्री एंड दिस हैव अ स्विंग ऑफ इट. सो दीज वेर द हैंगिंग रूट्स वेर विच वेर टचिंग टू द ग्राउंड एंड इट वॉज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू कट बिकॉज 50 मेन्स विद एक्सेस chopped and chopped this great banyan tree and it revealed the rings of 200 years ago. The result of cutting down the trees was the different insects and birds had to leave the tree because their nest which was on the tree was disturbed and they had to leave the tree. The image of poet search for the roots. There is a similarity between Dilip Chitre and the banyan tree. Dilip Chitre had shifted to Baroda from had shifted to Mumbai from Baroda, and therefore he felt uprooted here as I have mentioned, and therefore he had no roots now. In the similar way, after cutting down the banyan tree, which was mercilessly cut down due to the father's instruction, even the roots were disturbed and the banyan tree also had no roots now. So there is a similarity between Dilip Chitre's life and the banyan tree. So we can say that this poem is autobiographical poem where Dilip Chitre is revealing about his own lifestyle, or where Dilip Chitre is telling about his own life, where he wants to say that after shifting to Mumbai, he is uprooted and he wants to go back to his native place, where he feels that after going there, he would be leading a very peaceful life where it is not possible for him to lead in Mumbai. Thank you, everybody.